selection, the next selection in the 2012 draft will be made by the Pittsburgh Penguins.
And there is the earthquake here in Pittsburgh. A massive deal by the Penguins, who trade Jordan Staal, who was their second overall pick in 2006. He turned down a 10-year contract extension a couple of days ago. Now he goes to Carolina to play with his brother Eric.
Ray Shero could not allow this to fester. Jimmy Rutherford knew he was going to get Jordan Staal as a UFA. Give Ray Shero a ton of props. He had to work this out last night with his scouting staff and with his ownership. And what he did is he maximized an asset. Now they can slot Crosby 1, Malkin 2, Brandon Sutter 3, and either Craig Adams or Joe Vitale 4. Ryan Dumoulin is an A-level prospect out of Boston College, 6'3", 205 pounds. He'll remind you a lot of Robbie Scuderi. And with the 8th overall pick, I guarantee you Pittsburgh will go defense again. And don't forget their other prospects on defense, where they have Joe Morrow out of Portland, Scott Harrington out of London.
And by the way, Jordan Staal getting married tonight up in Thunder Bay. And so he gets dealt
on his wedding
on the night he gets hitched.
And Jordan Staal, expect Jordan Staal to be the number one center for the Carolina Hurricanes. What you say? Eric Stahl's the number one center. No, they'll probably move Eric Staal to the right wing. Jordan Staal will be the number one center, although they do have the option of going Eric number one and Jordan number two. I know the Carolina Hurricanes did not want to give up Brandon Sutter as part of this trade. They saw him as the number two center behind Jordan Staal when Jordan lines up on the same line with his brother Eric. But they had to give up quality to get quality. And this also frees up cap space for the Pittsburgh Penguins if they want to get into the Zach Parise sweepstakes.
They're going to be in the Zach Parise sweepstakes. Don't forget the connection between Shattuck St. Mary's graduates. Sidney Crosby and Zach Parise are tight. They're very tight. Zach Parise, if he doesn't re-sign with New Jersey, will be the apple of Ray Shero's eye. And it would not surprise me if the Pittsburgh Penguins, much like Los Angeles last year when they got Mike Richards, and we talked about it on this show, it would not surprise me what Ray Shero just did. He put the Pittsburgh Penguins in the driver's seat in the Eastern Conference to go compete for the Cup.
You know, both these general managers deserve a lot of credit.
Yes.
You're right. Ray Shero was in almost an untenable situation where he's got a star player like Jordan Staal, who basically turned down a 10-year, $60 million offer, knew that he was a year away from unrestricted free agency. No team could give market value for Jordan Staal, not knowing if they could get a deal done with him long-term. So one arm was tied behind Ray Shero's back in terms of the trade that he was making. The only place that would be able to get an extension done with Jordan Staal would be Carolina. Carolina could have sat back and said, you know what, we're not going to make that move. We're just going to wait for a year and get him unrestricted free agency. But they wanted to make the move now. They wanted to get him in-house. And they gave up a significant asset in Brandon Sutter and Dumoulin and the 8th overall pick to do it.
Well said, Bob, and you're right. And you know what, Jimmy Rutherford showed a lot of class, and the Carolina Hurricanes showed a lot of class. Ray Shero, Mario Lemieux, David Morehouse. That's Randy Sexton, former general manager in Ottawa and Florida, following behind Danny McKinnon, the chief pro scout. I would not be surprised to see Pittsburgh take a defenseman, and it wouldn't surprise me if it's a defenseman from the Western Hockey League. They really like Derek Pouliot, who plays with Joe Morrow in Portland.
Well, last year Minnesota made a big splash when it hosted the draft. Now the Pittsburgh Penguins have followed suit. And the last time the Penguins had a pick in the top 20 in the draft, they took Jordan Staal, second overall, back in 2006.
And it pained Ray Shero to have to trade him, but he had no choice. And good on everybody involved. This was a straight-up hockey deal for both groups. I give Jimmy Rutherford and Ray Shero a lot of credit. Both organizations showed a lot of class.
Pittsburgh a first-round defeat for the second consecutive year, so Shero also under pressure to shake things up. He did, and now he's got a pick.
The Pittsburgh Penguins have been extremely proud to host the 2012 NHL Entry Draft, and we thank our fans once again for your continued support. We'd also like to extend our congratulations to the LA Kings, General Manager Dean Lombardi, Head Coach Daryl Sutter, and on behalf of our ownership, management, coaches, to thank Jordan Staal for 6 great years here in Pittsburgh and a Stanley Cup in 2009. With the 8th pick in the 2012 entry draft, Pittsburgh selects from Portland Derek Pouliot.
Right. I knew that was coming, Gordon, Bob, because they've been in love with this player all year long. Remember, they took Joe Morrow in the 2011 entry draft with the 23rd pick. So they've been watching Pouliot play a ton. And you talk about offense and puck moving. This is a young man that's already played 3 years for the Portland Winterhawks. He's got unbelievable vision. He's been well-trained by Mike Johnson, the coach there. In 72 games, he had 59 points. This is a big-time NHL offensive catalyst kind of player.
And the funny thing is, a lot of people compare him to a guy Pittsburgh already has, Chris Letang.
Yeah, absolutely. 5'11", 192 pounds. The scouts I talked to said that you could argue he's the best transition defenseman in the game in terms of going back, picking up a puck, and getting his team out of trouble. The question is, he's not very big. He doesn't play an overly physical game. And was he willing to assert himself? He's a very quiet, shy kid off the ice and sometimes on the ice. It's almost as if he doesn't want to play outside his means. He doesn't want to force the issue at all. It'll be interesting to see if, with more confidence, he asserts himself more. But he is a skilled offensive defenseman. 11 goals, 59 points for the Portland Winterhawks. And you're right, Pierre. Teammates with Joe Morrow, another Pittsburgh Penguin first rounder.
And I'm telling you right now, gentlemen, what Pittsburgh's doing, they're loading up offensively. They're opening up cap space for Zach Parise. And when you think about Joe Morrow and the potential of him coming in here, and Scott Harrington, well-trained by the London Knights, Pittsburgh is going to be a defensive juggernaut and an offensive machine. This is scary for the rest of the Eastern Conference right now. In one fell swoop, Ray Shiro's basically changed the whole identity of the Pittsburgh Penguins, much like what Dean Lombardi did last year when Mike Richards went to Los Angeles.
Ran into Portland GM and coach Mike Johnson this year at the airport in Calgary. We were just talking, and he said, hey, there's a young guy on my team that you want to keep an eye on. He says, I'm telling you right now that Derek Pouliot is as good an offensive defenseman as I've seen in the Western Hockey League in a long time.
You're not lying. He's telling the truth. He is that good. And if he was not available, I think Pittsburgh might have gone in a different direction. But with him being available, there's Jay Heinbach, the chief scout with Marilyn Yeux. They would have gone in another direction. They wanted this player.
Well, fans in Pittsburgh came to see action at the draft, and they got it in a big way.
There's still some more to come, I think.
So here is a look. So far, we've had 8 picks in the draft. Thus far, 6 have been D-men.
Not surprising. Bob talked about it. Gord, you talked about it. I know Craig Button talked about it. We all talked about it. This is a draft for defensemen. This is not about offensive impetus for your team. That being said, if you look at what Ray Shiro just did for Pittsburgh, they've added offense, they've added defense, and they've added the potential of adding an unbelievable player in Zach Parise if he doesn't sign with New Jersey.
All right, let's send you to James Duthie with the newsmaker.
Yes, it is. Ray Shiro, the general manager of the Pittsburgh Penguins, an unusual wedding gift to let a guy play with his brother. I appreciate your originality. When did you decide you had to make this deal? Was it when Jordan turned down the long 10-year contract yesterday?
Not really. I mean, we were prepared to move forward with Jordan for next year and to kind of see what happens. But, you know, the more we thought about it, the more teams had called. And I just felt, and as an organization, we felt it was the right thing to do for Jordan. He's ready for an expanded role, and he's ready to expand his wings here. And Carolina certainly is a great place for him and his new wife, Heather. So congratulations to them, and hopefully it's a good deal for him, and he's happy. And but a wonderful 6 years here for Pittsburgh and Jordan Staal.
Have you spoken to Jordan?
No, I left him a message. I figured he's tied up in his wedding, but I sent him. I left a message on a text, so I hope to talk to him maybe tomorrow when things quiet down.
Was it contingent on this player, Pouliot, being available at this spot, the deal?
No.
So you would have taken it no matter what.
Yeah.
How hard is it for you to break up these three centers in Crosby, Malkin, and Staal that for a while it looked like would be the next decade in Pittsburgh?
Yeah, well, I think the reality of the salary cap, the reality of having three centers that are this good, you know, especially with Jordan Staal, I mean, at some point here, he's, you know, 24 years old. As I said, he's ready for a more expanded role. And it's time for him to go. And, you know, at my first ever draft pick here in Pittsburgh. So it's tough. And a lot of respect for Jordan, wonderful family, and but you know it's a good return for us. Brandon Sutter is going to be a real good player for us. Eric Pouliot, obviously a future defenseman, and of course Brian DeMoline from Boston College has turned pro already. So hopefully it's good for both Carolina and Pittsburgh.
It's fascinating to listen to the crowd's reaction. I'm sure somewhat of a relief to you. The huge boos when it's announced. And they announced, okay, the 8th pick, so there's some cheers. Then huge cheers with Sutter. And then when the entire deal is complete, it's pretty much a loud standing ovation.
Yeah, as it should be with Jordan Staal. I mean, you know, it's one thing. I mean, you make a draft pick, you win a Stanley Cup with him. He's forever going to be tied to Pittsburgh and the Penguins. He has her name on a Stanley Cup with us. But it's a good day for Jordan. It really is. Obviously, getting married today, and that's the best part. Hope the next best part is moving on to play with his brother Eric in Carolina.
Thanks for this, Ray. Appreciate it.
No problem. Thank you.
Let us recap the trade for you, excuse me. And it is a big one. There have been numerous trades on this day. This is number four, but the biggest one so far is Jordan Staal, the Stanley Cup winner, goes to join Eric in Carolina. Derek Pouliot, the player the Penguins just drafted, Brandon Sutter, and Brian Dumoulin come back the other way. So Pittsburgh with a major move, and for the second straight year, the host of the draft makes a significant move. Remember, the Wild and Brent Burns last year at the draft in Minnesota. Let's send it down to Darren Dreger on the draft floor.
All right, James, thanks very much. Joined by Jim Rutherford of the Carolina Hurricanes, the architect of this deal. Jim, how quickly did this deal come together? It's a big one.
Yeah, it was pretty quick. I mean, I made Ray aware that we had interest in Jordan after their season, but this really took place about 4:30 this afternoon. I got a call from him. He came over and met him in his office, and we completed it about 6:45.
It's a hockey deal. You get a very good player in Jordan Staal, but you also gave up some very good talent, future, and present. I know you didn't want to include Brandon Sutter. Was that key in getting this deal done?
Yeah, that was key, and we did not want to let him go. We love Brandon Sutter. He's a great player. He's got a great future ahead of him, but when you're making a deal like this for an elite player, you have to make a hockey deal, and you have to put certain pieces in. And he had to be part of the deal.
Congratulations and good luck.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, we're only through eight picks already. A fascinating day at the 2012 NHL Draft. The next Canadian team, the Winnipeg Jets, are up next when we continue.
Welcome to Winnipeg and welcome to the Jets home. Big save by Andre Pavlik. They're on their feet.
Dustin Byfuglien with a bomb.
That's desperation. That's athletic. That's one heck of a save.
Wheeler commands scores.
We just got to make sure that moving forward we get the right mindset to, you know, get into the playoffs.
Welcome back to the 2012 NHL Draft, where it's been an eventful first hour or so. The Winnipeg Jets are up next at number 9. Kevin Cheveldayoff and company getting set to make their selection. Here's Gordon Miller.
Well, James, the return of the NHL to Winnipeg was one of the great feel-good stories of this National Hockey League season, and no one welcomed them more than longtime player agent Don Baisley, a Winnipeg native who's been a fixture here at the NHL Draft since the late 1970s. Baisley is the rarest of all things, a universally respected hockey figure and agent, and a guy who's been battling some health issues of late. We understand he's on the mend and feeling better in Winnipeg, but for the first time in more than 30 years, Don is not here at the draft, and your many, many friends in the hockey community, Don, want you to know that you are very much missed and very much being thought of this weekend. And the Jets will now make their second first-round pick. They took Mark Scheifele last year, and now they'll make a first-round pick after missing the playoffs in their first year in Winnipeg.
On behalf of the Winnipeg Jets organization, I'd like to say hello to all our passionate fans watching back in Winnipeg and at our official team draft party at the Tavern United Transcona. And on behalf of all the management and teams here in the hockey world, we'd like to pass along our best wishes to player representative Don Baisley, who's back at home right now in Winnipeg, unable to be with us at the draft this weekend for the first time in his career. The Winnipeg Jets are proud to select from the U.S. Development Program, Jacob Trouba.
Jacob Trouba, the big defenseman. His dad's 6'9". He's not as big as that, but he's still a big boy who hasn't even filled out yet, 185 pounds. But a big physical defenseman who's going to the University of Michigan next year. At least he's scheduled to play at the University of Michigan next year, unless the Winnipeg Jets suggest otherwise. in which case his rights are owned by the Kitchener Rangers of the Ontario Hockey League.